Imagine being flung into ice cold water. That's how this little fellow would feel if he were in this room. Normal room temperature to a premature baby is the same as what you and I would feel if we were flung into ice cold water. India has 8 million of these guys born every year. The world over, you have 20 million of them. We've known for almost 100 years that keeping babies warm will actually have them live longer. How many of you here have taken care of a baby as soon as it's been born? Let's see. Quite a few. What do babies do in the first month of life? They basically, they sleep, they drink milk, they poop. That's because they're busy growing. Unfortunately, these guys struggle to stay warm and therefore are unable to grow in that first month of life. Their internal organs don't develop, and if they don't die, they grow up to have lifelong illnesses. And this is a solution. These devices are called incubators. They're little glass boxes that keep, whose primary function is to keep a baby warm. Unfortunately, in countries like ours, these are available only in city hospitals. Most babies don't get access to them. And this is where Embrace comes in. Embrace is a social enterprise founded at Stanford, where we are trying to bring to market an infant warmer, a low-cost infant warmer, that can keep these babies warm with or without electricity. I have it right here, actually. It looks like a tiny sleeping bag. And I'll tell you why it looks like that. The essential technology is in this pouch. It's something called a phase change material. It's a special material that has that once you warm it up, has the ability to maintain a constant temperature for at least 4 hours. What you do is there's this heating device that sits here. You pop it in there. In about 20 minutes, the pouch will have melted and it'll be good to go. You pop it into the backside of this sleeping bag, into a compartment here. Open it up and have the baby lie in here. Like I said, it looks nothing like a glass box. It can work with or without electricity. It has no moving parts. As you can see, it's portable. It's not tied to a hospital. You don't need to plug it in. It's easy to clean. And most importantly, and this is why it doesn't look like a glass box, it allows mother-child interaction. As soon as a baby is born, the best place for the baby to be is next to his mother. And it's been designed to keep local sensibilities in mind. The most common practice you have in India is swaddling a baby. And then you provide skin-to-skin care for a baby. It is a practice that's extremely beneficial for babies. And that is why this doesn't look like a glass box. There's a numerous little bits have gone into it to make this appropriate for a developing country context. Any guesses as to why this thing has a shape? There's a little notch here. It's because when you pop into this heater, it should only be popped one way. It shouldn't be popped the other way around. And it turns out that thanks to the proliferation of cell phones, most people know what a SIM card looks like. About a year ago, I was in a village outside Mancher. Mancher is a town outside Pune. I was talking to a group of mothers there. And we had a temperature indicator on this thing. And I was talking to them, telling them that, hey, the right temperature for a baby is 37 degrees Celsius. So you're supposed to warm this up till 37 degrees Celsius. And after which it'll stay warm for 4 hours and so on. They look at me and say, you know, Western medicine, allopathic medicine, is really strong. So if my doctor asked me to give my baby 1 teaspoon of medicine, I usually give him half. Just to be safe. So if you tell me to heat this at 37, I'm going to heat it to like 25, 30, just to be safe. Makes complete sense from their perspective. And I have alarm bells going on in my head. Right? So what we did was we redesigned the temperature indicator, took away the choice from the user. We made it a smiley face and a frowny face. If it's in the right temperature, it's a green smiley face. Wrong temperature, red frowny face. That's all. The reason I gave these examples is you will see that this is not a technology that was developed in the West 50 years ago that has been adapted to a developing country context. To solve world's leading issues that are in developing countries, you need solutions that are developed with the context in mind. You need to immerse yourself in the context, understand people's mindsets. Only then can you actually get yourself to really tackle the problems at hand. Over the next 5 years, we hope to give the millions of these babies born in our country a fighting chance to live. Join us in our journey as we try and democratize technology, bring the benefits of, meet human needs, actually, through technology and business, and ultimately help our mothers and doctors take better care of our babies. Thank you.